Dear friends, welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, we are going to learn how to use this 2.9-inch e-paper display with the ESP32 board. Let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects. In this channel, I share everything about the project I built to help you develop similar projects or inspire you to start making this because it is easy, fun and creative. Subscribe to the channel now if you don't want to miss any future video. A few weeks ago, I made a video about this small 1.5-inch e-paper display and I built a simple thermometer with it in another video. You can watch those videos by clicking on the cards here. I really like e-paper displays and when I discovered this big 2.9-inch e-paper display, I ordered one to test it. The display costs around $23. You can find a link to it below. Compared to the 1.5-inch display, which costs around $20, the bigger display offers better value for money, but it is still expensive for most projects. The reason I like to use e-paper displays is that they have some unique characteristics. E-paper or electronic paper are displays that, unlike traditional LCD or OLED displays, does not emit light but reflect light. It is like the ink on the paper. This characteristic makes e-paper displays very comfortable to read and they have excellent readability under direct sunlight. Another great thing about e-paper displays is that they can hold static text and images for months without electricity. Yes, that's correct, the display can show text and images even when it is off. That makes e-paper displays ideal for low-powered projects. Unfortunately, there are some disadvantages as well. The price of e-paper displays is still very high. Another significant disadvantage is that e-paper displays take a lot of time to update, as much as 2 to 3 seconds. So, they are only helpful for static text and images and not animations. Let's now see how to use this 2.9-inch e-paper display with the ESP32 board. The display offers a resolution of 296 by 128 pixels and it uses the SPI interface to communicate with the microcontroller. You can use any 3.3-volt microcontroller you wish. I prefer to use the ESP32 board, which is inexpensive and very powerful. I am using this DOIT ESP32 development board. There is a newer version of the board, this one, which offers more pins, which works fine with the display as well, using the same pins. It is a 3.3-volt display, so VCC must be connected to the 3.3-volt output of the ESP32 port. The next pin is ground and it goes to ground. The third pin is named D-in and it goes to digital pin 23. The fourth pin is clock and it goes to digital pin 18. The fifth pin, CS, goes to digital pin 5. The sixth pin to digital pin 22. The seventh pin to digital pin 21. And the last pin to digital pin 4. That's it! We are now ready to load a sketch to the ESP32 port and watch the display in action. If we power up the project, we can see that it successfully drives the display. I have loaded a simple sketch, which at first it displays some text and then some bitmap images I have loaded. As you can see, the display works fine and once every few seconds it displays a new code. If I unplug the board from power, you can see that the display does not go blank. It retains the bitmap image intact without using any power at all. That's why I love e-paper technology so much. Let's now go to the computer to see the software side of the project. We are using the GXEPD library in this example. As you can see, at the setup function, I am displaying some text, and then I display some bitmap images one after another. The bitmap images are converted to data arrays using the image to LCD software. I'll show you how. Let's add another bitmap image to the project. We are going to use paint.net, a free image editor. At first, we create a new document and we enter the resolution of the display here, 296 pixels width and 128 pixels in height. Next, we design the bitmap file we want to load to the display. I will create another Elon Musk what file here. When ready, we select File, Save As, and we save the file as a bitmap file. Now we have to load another software in order to convert the bitmap file we just created to a data array that the GXEPD library can use. We load the image to LCD software, we open the bitmap file we created and it appears on the screen. We select vertical scan here and we enter the resolution of the display here, 296 here and 128 here, and we press this small button here. Next, we unpress this checkbox and check this one. Then we press save and the software will create a data array. Now, all we have to do is to copy this array and paste it into the bitmapgraphics.h file like this. Now we can use this bitmap image in the project. If we upload the sketch to the ESP32 board once more, we can see that it displays the new bitmap just fine. You can find the code of the project and the image to LCD software in the description of the video below. I really like this e-paper display because it is bigger and it needs no power when it is not updating. I am thinking of creating a simple project with it. If you are a long-time viewer of the channel, you know that I love quotes. So I am going to build a simple device which will remind me of a new quote once a day using this display. It can be battery-powered since the display will be updated once a day. I think it will be cool. Stay tuned. I would love to hear your opinion about this e-paper display. Do you like it and are you going to use it in any of your projects? Please post your comments below. Thanks. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects twice a month. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. I'll see you in the next video.